Your Facebook business manager is more than likely set up incorrectly. This isn't good news, but you're in good company. Most people get this wrong right out the gate.
In this video, we're going to cover how to verify, optimize, and protect your Facebook business manager.
Getting this infrastructure correct from the start will avoid some serious headaches. You've heard the nightmare stories or have felt them yourself, waking up one morning and your account is disabled. Facebook is an easy scapegoat, and we all have Facebook nightmare stories, but to be quite frank, 50% of all of these issues are your and my fault. By not getting this right in the beginning, we've hurt our accounts and our clients' accounts, knowingly or unknowingly. In this video, we're going to cover three of the most important things in having a healthy business manager account. The first is going to be the account hierarchy. It sounds boring, but it's not. It's very important. It's how Facebook views it, and if you skip it, you will burn in hell. We're also going to be covering verifying your business manager. Now, this is absolutely critical. Facebook wants to make sure that there's a real human being at the other end of that business manager that has the ability to spend money and promote things. If you don't verify your business manager, you're actually limiting the access to tools that you have. iOS changes are coming down the pipeline, and the way pixel data is going to be transferred over to the aggregated data measurement, you won't have access to it without verifying your business. That's just one of the many things you won't have access to that could prevent you from running really efficient and profitable ads. And then we're going to cover adding people to your business manager. We're going to do this in two levels. We're going to add a staff member, and we're going to add an outside contractor. My goal for shooting this tutorial is to help you use all the bells and whistles that Facebook has to offer and be competitive while doing it, and also limit the kind of issues outside influences could have in your account by just giving them the wrong level of access. When you get through this, you're going to feel empowered to educate your clients and your staff on how to use Facebook Business Manager like a pro.
So why does this matter?
If you log into business.facebook.com and it looks something like this, you're doing it wrong. When it's connected like this, that means that your personal profile is connected to every one of these businesses. This is bad for you and it's bad for the businesses. Now, if you're a business owner, you want to be able to protect your Facebook page, your Instagram account, your ad accounts, your pixel data, and you don't want to have people who aren't critical to your organization have access to your business manager. Great example. If I have direct access to your business manager as an outside consultant and my phone gets hacked, now they have access to your business manager. They can remove you from it and suddenly you don't own your own business anymore. If you're a business owner, this may sound a little confusing, but Facebook has done such a bad job at explaining how business manager access works that I almost think it's intentional. Inviting somebody to work on your business manager is drastically different than giving them access to limiting tools to work on your behalf. You might give your business partner admin access, but you may want to give me just access to your Facebook pixel and your ads account. Whomever has access to your business manager, Facebook looks at those people as some sort of responsible party for your business. Let me tell you a personal horror story. I woke up one morning, opened up my computer, and there's a red bar of death. I was prohibited from accessing any Facebook account I was managing because my profile got suspended. Here's what happened while I was sleeping. This was at the beginning of COVID, and one of the accounts that I managed was a supplement company. They thought it'd be a great idea to create an ad that says that their supplement basically cures COVID. What a nightmare. Because they did this and I was associated to their business manager, this locked me out of every account I managed. So I had my clients who weren't these crazy people, their ad spending all day long and I had zero access. Luckily, it was at the beginning of the pandemic and the chat message still worked with Facebook and I got it resolved in about 24 hours. This would have never happened if it was properly assigned to begin with. Another reason you want to set this up correctly is because as an agency owner, you may have your staff members that need to access client asset folders or ad accounts or Instagram. You don't want every one of the people that works for you to have to request access to a business manager. You just want to be able to assign them within your own business manager access to those levels. So much easier, so much smoother, and it's super professional. Let's jump into Facebook account hierarchy. Do not skip this. It'll make you a better business owner and a better marketer, I promise you. Account hierarchy starts with your personal profile. This is the profile that is connected to you. You don't want to go out and create one just for business operations. This will eventually get you in hot water in some way, shape, or form. I promise you, I've seen it a million times. You want to use the one that's connected to you, that your mom, your sister, your brother, your wife, your husband, your daughter, all those people know, that's the one you have to use. That is how you open your business manager or accept an invite to one. That's the account we want to work from. Now, that business manager of yours, that's connected to your business. The way Facebook looks at it is that is your business. And you're connected to your payment structure, how you pay for ads. Your credit card information is in there. All the location and address and your business EIN number is there as well. You're also looking at what staff members from your organization are connected to it. Facebook has built this to protect you, believe it or not. And if it's used correctly, that's exactly what it does. Now, if you are running an account and you're giving people access to your Facebook through this alone, this is meant just for staff members, just for admin members, people directly related to your business. When you see this, you gotta make sure this is somebody that you would give the keys to your business to, and they can open it up at 2 or 3 a.m. You don't wanna give this to an outside contractor. There's a different setting for that called partners. And you can add a partner by giving them your assets directly or requesting assets from them. And really a partner, they're gonna use their partner business ID. A partner business ID, that number that you're granting access to, that's somebody else's business manager. So you're not granting their profile access, you're granting another business manager access. So the best way to think about this is, if you're giving somebody access to your business manager through email, they're directly related to your business. If you're using the partner ID, what they most likely are is an outside contractor. So emails for people you know, numbers are for people who need limited access. Now the thing that your business manager has underneath it is your pages, ad accounts, business asset groups, apps, Instagram account, the catalog of items you may be selling, pixel data, custom conversions, shared audiences, business creative folders, domains, block list, and leads access. You may need an outside marketer or developer to have access to any one of those at any given time. If they had access to your business manager, we already know what kind of issues that causes, but through partners, you can share specific assets at any given time and remove it whenever you see fit. So you may have an agency that's working on your behalf, and you give that agency access to your page, your Instagram, and your ad account. And now that agency can work, their entire team has access to those assets of yours and can work there without needing access to your business manager. You may have a developer developing a custom app for you. They may need access to the app segment and to custom conversions, for instance. No matter what services you need to give somebody access to, by granting partner access, you're limiting your exposure. It cannot be any more simple than that. Now, wouldn't you sleep way easier at night if you only had to manage one account that had access this cleanly? We're about to verify your business manager, but there's a handful of things you're gonna need ready. The first is you're gonna need a backup admin. My wife is the backup admin on our business page. Somebody you trust, somebody you would give the keys to your front door. That's the best person to put as a backup admin. Then you're gonna need your phone with two-factor authentication app. Something by Google or Microsoft will work here. You're also going to need access to the website, and I mean direct access to the website. You're gonna have to put a code into the head of the homepage document or have access to the DNS file because we're gonna have to put a text file into that. If there's a business phone number and it's not your cell phone, you're gonna need access to that as well because Facebook's gonna send a verification code either through text or through calling it. You're gonna get to pick, but you're gonna have to have access to that. And then business documentation proving your real business. And think, I'm starting a bank account. You're gonna need articles of incorporation. You may need a lease that has your phone number or your address on it. You may need a utility bill that has your address or your phone number on it. Something that really proves that you are a business owner. If you have all those, ready to move on. And the first place we wanna start at is under accounts, let's go to apps. When you click apps, you're gonna see, hey, we don't have one. And this sounds more complicated than it is. It's absolutely critical we get this app built right now. It'll take 2 seconds. Facebook has done a really poor job of explaining why you need this. And under Business Manager, under apps, when you don't have one, you have to go to developers.facebook.com. There you click My Apps on the top right, and you're gonna hit Create a New App. The first option you have is Manage Business Integrations. This is the one you need to click on and hit continue. And then you're going to put in the name of the app, which is going to be front facing. And this is going to be copy.com because that's the name of the business. And I'm just going to put biz app. I want to be able to know in my business manager what this app does, because later you're going to have custom apps for your business. Let's distinguish which one's there to just to verify it. Make sure your contact information is correct, and then the app purpose. You can build these for your clients or yourself. In this case, we're building it for ourselves. And then we're going to click which business manager is associated. When you click here, you might have a slew of business managers or just one ideally. And then you hit create app. Once you hit create app, it's going to populate there and you're going to see something like this. So this app that I have is connected to my profile and to my business manager, giving me two more points of contact with business manager. From there, we're going to go down and we're going to hit domains. When we get to domains, we're going to hit add a new domain. The reason we want to add a domain is we want to prove to Facebook that the business that we're managing and the ads that we're running, we have full authorship and authority over that website. So you can do this in a handful of ways. For us, we can do it through a meta tag. So it's this tag that Facebook provides. You put it into the head of the document of your website, then come back and hit verify. Once you hit verify, Facebook takes 2-3 seconds and says, boom, you're good to go. We know you own the website. If you don't have access to your website through the front end, through the code, or just don't want to mess with the code, you could also do it through DNS verification. I actually prefer this because it's a lot easier for me, but when you go through DNS, you're gonna use this code as well. You're gonna put a text file and you're gonna put the host name as the at symbol and then this string of text. Come back to this and hit verify. This may take 24 to 48 hours at times, but once you prove to Facebook that you own the business and the website, the next step is to prove that this business you have full control of outside in the real world. And that's where business info comes into play. The business details here are very straightforward. They're asking the legal name of the business, the address the business is located in, what number we need to reach the business at, what's your EIN number. They say it's optional, but I highly recommend you put it there. And then, of course, the website, because this website has to correlate to the website we just validated through domains. You have to put the items in here that match the business documents you have. So if your articles of incorporation or business license say you're at 123 Main Street, make sure you put 123 Main Street in the address here. If the number is 555-55555, make sure that's the phone number that's added here. Once you have these set, you're gonna see that this area down here, business verification status, may have a gray check mark to it, not ready to go. It's okay. We've got our business details in there, and then we're gonna hit view details. Here's an account that doesn't have it operational. And underneath this account, as you can see, this is not verified. So when we hit view details, we're gonna have to get some things right in the beginning before we can even start the verification. We have to get two-factor authentication. So right now, this is set to no one, admins only, or everyone. We want everyone, anyone who has access to our business account needs to have two-factor authentication set up on their phone. That's gonna limit the ease of being hacked and somebody taking over the account. And it's also gonna protect your core assets for your business manager. You're gonna make sure you have a backup admin. Also important, because if you lose access, they need to be able to get in there and re-grant you access later. And then once you're there, you're gonna hit start verification. This is where Facebook is going to ask you a handful of things that are very relevant to your business. They're gonna ask you, what address are you at? You're gonna put it in there because you know what it is. Then they're gonna tell you, what phone number should we reach you at? You're gonna give it to them. And then they're gonna have a items folder that opens up. Make sure you set it to English and then upload your business documents, your articles of incorporation, a business license, a utility bill, anything that validates what you've put on the back end saying where your business is located and who owns it. Then they're gonna say, great, we got your information. Now we're gonna either send a text or call the business phone number. Be ready for that call because it's gonna give you a 6-digit number. Once you get that call and you put that 6-digit number, they're going to say, great, we've got everything we need. Now we're gonna validate your real business. A real human being is gonna get an alert in Facebook. They're gonna look at your account, look at the documents you provided, and verify that all of these things make sense. And when they do, they're gonna verify your business, unlocking the ability to do a lot more with your business account. Now, let's jump into granting access two ways. The first way we're gonna grant access is to somebody who can add a credit card to our business that may need to adjust other permissions and give granted access to other employees. So we'll call them a manager. And we do that under people, and we hit add. When we add this person, we're gonna use it through their email. So we're gonna use the email that's most likely associated with their profile. In this case, crystal@jojo.com. She's the one getting access. And crystal@jojo.com, she's not just an employee access, she's gonna be admin level access. I'm gonna hit next. And then we're gonna pick which pages, ad accounts, catalogs, apps, and pixels she can have access to and to what degree. So we can pick this one right here and we can say, hey, look, you can have access to this page and you can get it to publish content, view earnings insights, and manage the page. View earnings insights is something you rarely don't have to give to somebody, but this is a complete top level manager access. But let's say they were an employee and they needed just access to the ad account to run some ads. You can click the ad account and you could say, in this one, I just need you to view performance and manage the campaigns. I don't want to give you full admin control to that ad account. So now this person works directly for the company. How do we know that? Because we're granting them access through their email. Once we hit next and continue, that invite will be sent to their inbox. They'll hit next and they'll have access to your business manager at degrees of levels you've allowed it to happen. But again, they should work directly for you or you should know them. Now we're going to give a contractor access. The best way to do this is to either ask them for their partner ID number or to send them your partner ID number. And the way to find a partner ID number is at the bottom here where it says business info, click it. And then go over and you'll see business manager ID. This is your partner ID number, copy it. Then go up here to partners and you can hit add. And now you can either give partner access to your assets or you can ask partner to share their assets. So if I want you to manage my account, I could say give partner my assets, put their ID number into this and then hit next. And then I will pick which assets they have access to. One of the things that you could do to simplify your life is use business asset groups. So as multiple accounts start being attached to your business manager, you're gonna have multiple pages, multiple pixels, multiple ad accounts, you're just gonna have multiple catalogs and audiences. And it's great to be able to group them together so you can give your admin manager, company X's, full access here with one click. The way you do that is you build a business asset group. So company X has given you access to all of these items. Instead of granting somebody else access one item at a time, you go to business asset groups and you hit add. And then you're able to add it in a handful of ways. You can do it as separate brands or lines of business, different regions, territory, an agency, so somebody who's working on your behalf, or other. So separate brands and lines of businesses means this business is a holding company and these businesses under it are DBA that have access to it. So that's just one way to do it. Another is different regions. So this is the main business manager we all have access to as a corporation, but each one of those locations has its own entity and that's why we're giving it a business asset group. Or it's an agency that manages your account or multiple accounts for you. So in this case, we're going to pick agency. We're going to hit confirm. We're going to give it a name. So in this, it's going to be Company X. And then next. And then we're able to link pages, ad accounts, pixels, Instagram accounts, offline events, catalogs, apps, custom conversions, and business creative folders into one. So I want to say this page, this ad account, this pixel, and this Instagram account all belong under one business asset group for Company X. They're all linked. When I hit next, it links them all together. And now that you have that, you can click on one and you can grant anybody in your company access to all of those assets with just one click. That'll make your life so much easier. And then again, if that person no longer works for you or they're finished with a project, you just go and remove them one time. You don't have to ask for permission from the company you represent. You don't have to go and get another business manager to come in and remove somebody. You just go right here and hit remove. Very straightforward. All right, we've covered hierarchy. We've verified our business manager and we've granted proper levels of access to staff and contractors. you can rest easy at night knowing you've done everything you can to future-proof your business manager. Sort of. Facebook is weird. Don't count on this being permanent. Things change. But for right now, this is the best practices directly from Facebook in how to optimize your business manager for true success. In the show notes, I have a link to a downloadable checklist to make your life way easier when you're setting up your business manager. If you found this helpful or insightful, please hit the subscribe button. And if you need somebody to look at your Facebook or Google Ads performance and give you a real deal audit on how to improve performance, head over to thankyou.com. That's what I do for a living. Have a f-ing great day.